Tell you what, you bring on one special guest and the entire damn podcast shows up. What the hell, guys?
Here we go.
I think the words you were looking for were, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you all for showing up.
I don't
all
think this 27 is my glass.
Of us.
Yep.
You're the only one drinking a white Russian and it's not your glass.
Yeah, it's 9 o'clock
it's
in the morning.
It's not my glass. Isn't my glass blue?
Oh, you mean your glass blown?
Yeah,
thing. Yeah. No, that's not it.
Paula,
I was like,
glass.
I don't think this is my glass. I don't know what this is on my glass.
That's a Chevy production line.
Oh, all right. Is this from the GM plant from around the corner?
Yeah. My grandfather worked for him.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So those are glasses he got.
Did he work for it until it closed?
Dude, like, you need to put those in like
a
case.
No. He left a little while beforehand.
GM is toast. Yep. You need to put that in a case or something.
Yeah.
I've got four more of them.
So. Well, then put the others in.
What are they called? Shadow boxes. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
They're surprisingly difficult to find. Not that I've ever tried, but...
Sounds like you've tried.
I was going to say, I don't think you mean that.
It's like a shadow display box.
Yeah, just display boxes for stuff, yeah.
I forget, why are we here?
I mean...
What year is it?
Let's intro. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Threading and Dreading. We have a very packed house tonight.
Oh, that's right. That's why we're here. Thanks, Michael.
And we decided to go to the smallest room we could find.
I thought we were just here for the free mimosas.
Yes. Yeah. It is a morning. It is an early morning. We all have mimosas, and they are quite tasty. Hopefully, I made good proportions for everyone.
Mm-hmm. I'll give you a proportion.
Oh, it was good. I'm probably going to have that other one, too.
Go for it.
We'll split it.
Yeah, that was Will's, so you can grab Will's if you want.
Yep.
I can grab Will's.
But I once again am the Projectionist.
I'm going
to
go.
And to my right, we have...
The Goddess of Gore.
And how are you?
I'm sleepy.
You're sleepy.
Because it's fucking
I thought
early.
You were going to use your new catchphrase, Gorific.
Oh, right.
Yeah, you're gorgeous.
I said that.
Sometimes I still wonder if she knows they're dating.
And next to the Goddess of Gore we have?
I think I'm the Black Lantern.
You're Black Lantern.
I'm Black
yes.
Lantern.
Because you have no soul.
I actually had to fact check that with my friend to my right here. And I'm doing great. Better than Will.
Thank you for coming.
That's how we're going to be.
I am the new metric.
Everyone is basing
that
their
is judgment. Like, it's very easy to compare.
We all curved our grades on Will.
And next to the Black Lantern we have?
The fangirl extraordinaire.
And how are you?
I'm okay. Good.
You're better than Will.
Yeah.
It's going to be the theme of the podcast here.
And next to the fangirl, we have someone who has not joined us for a very, very long time.
It's been almost 4 years.
Almost 4 years. According to the calendar with all the X's on it, it's been exactly 10 months.
We have the superhuman aficionado.
I don't even get to introduce myself.
Yeah.
That's fine. But hold on. Here, put your glass down. Because together, Karen and I are ready.
No.
Don't do it.
No.
No.
You're not ready?
No.
We're not doing it. You're not ready.
Don't force it.
No, I don't remember.
You're the
it's
Wonder
been
Twins.
So okay. Long. All
right, never mind. Give her back her liquor.
Form of a mimosa.
Form of a mimosa. Shape of a glass.
But how have you been, sir?
I've been all right. You know, life, two jobs, family crap.
And you brought your sidekick, Appa?
I brought my trusty steed. He's my jerk-off little dog. For whatever reason, my boyfriend is a huge dog guy, but he's allergic to the oils in Appa's fur. So,
oh, really?
Yeah, so they can't cuddle, and also Appa's kind of a dick towards him sometimes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So,
that should tell you something.
No judgment. Appa's a dick.
Well, we're happy to have you both back. Thanks for coming back, man. And next to the superhuman aficionado, we have...
A fragile piece of glass that could break at any moment.
Called the Dystopian.
That'll be the fourth time he said that.
I was going to say, that's the other theme of the morning.
Fragile piece of glass that could break at any moment.
Shape of a glass.
Please lower
shape of
that
glass.
Could break at any moment.
Please lower your voice.
And thank you for coming.
Don't yell.
I apologize for the loudness and the crudeness of our podcast today, Dystopian. I hope we don't making you suffer in any way.
Rudeness.
I'll just have some Tums.
We could say the word moist a lot.
You have a whole bag of Tums, just be popping them like chiclets the whole time. But we have one more guest joining us today. Ladies and gentlemen, from the Ragecast, as well as the new channel on YouTube called History Buffs, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Nick Hodges.
Yay!
Hello!
Yay. Such a pleasure to have you.
Thanks. Is this where we insert like that black and white theater and everybody's like yay and like raving
you
reviews?
You mean the applause?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
That's what I said.
Cue applause, please.
Yay!
Rabble, rabble, rabble.
Hi guys.
It's hard to do.
Thank
with
you
one
for coming
hand.
On, Nick. It's great for having you on.
The one hand.
No,
applause.
It's an absolute pleasure to be here. Thanks very much for inviting me.
And I do have to say, I've checked out a couple of your videos on History Buffs, and it is a very, very good channel. I love what you're doing. For those of you who don't know, do you want to give a quick explanation of what you have going on over there?
Okay. Well, basically, it's just a film review series that focuses only on historical films. And my job is to let the audience know how accurate the film was to the historical setting. So how accurate is Apollo 13 or Zulu or Kingdom of Heaven? And so I sort out the good films from the bad films. But sometimes I point out, like, if the film is inaccurate, that doesn't necessarily mean that the film's going to be crap.
Oh, of course.
Sometimes where those are quite necessary, you know, to entertain the audience.
Exactly. Have you done Kingdom of Heaven?
Yeah, well, so I've done five. So far I've done Zulu, Gladiator, Kingdom of Heaven, The Last Samurai, and We Were Soldiers.
Nice.
And I'm releasing, hopefully, next weekend, my favorite historical inspirations behind Game of Thrones. Because that show and those books are so just chock full of stuff that's related to our history.
Absolutely. Yeah. I do have to say, Kingdom of Heaven is probably one of my favorite period pieces. That is probably one... I saw it in theaters and wasn't great, but then when I saw the director's cut, it blew my freaking mind.
Oh, dude, I had so much grief because I did not watch the director's cut. Because I watched the theatrical version, and then I was like, I know that there's like a director's cut somewhere, so I went looking for it, and I found the special edition. So I thought, okay, so that's the version. And then people are like, no, that's the director's cut. So I'm like, well, how many fucking editions are there? And I'm like, oh, yeah, it's Ridley Scott. I mean, this is the guy who has like five different versions of Blade Runner. So.
Right, right. The extended Supremo fuck you edition.
Exactly, yeah. Funny enough, that's the one I get the most grief on, you know. People are like, is there another edition where this happens and this happens? I'm like,
there's one where Ridley Scott comes on stage and does a vaudeville dance. You have to watch that one.
Oh, I love that one. That's my favorite.
So thank you for coming on, Nick. It's a pleasure to have you.
No, it's great. Thanks. It's been almost 2 years since I've done a podcast with a big group of people, so it's blast from the past, man. It's quite nostalgic to do this again.
You're on the Ragecast occasionally, aren't you?
I am, but like it's just Jeff and I, whereas when I was doing the Loading Bar there was like five people at the same time and all screaming over each other.
I can't imagine how that...
This feels more like the Loading Bar than Rage Cast.
Yeah, we don't
Rage
scream over each other.
Shut the hell up!
No, you shut up!
Everybody shut the hell up!
Loud noises.
I love lamp!
Why are we yelling?
All right, well, great to have you on, Nick. Is there any news you guys wanted to bring up real quick? We cut out our portion of movie news, Nick. We don't really cover that anymore because by the time we got out the podcast, the movie news was just obsolete by that point. But is there anything you guys want to bring up before we get into the trailers?
Hold on.
Is that a yes?
I'm sorry. No.
Are you making yourself another white Russian?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Also, I couldn't find any open vodka, so I opened a bottle of vodka.
Don't you work today?
Wait a minute. What time is it over there?
It is
9:58.
I was going to ask you what time it was.
It's 10 a.m. in the morning, and you're drinking fucking white Russians.
I didn't want to be out of place because I don't like champagne.
And the rest
to
of
be
us
fair,
everybody else is drinking mimosas.
That's just a superhuman aficionado. Every
like
podcast
so
he has a white
Russian. This is what I do. All right, so I don't have movie news per se, but it's been a while since I've been on, so I'm going to geek it up for a second.
Okay, go ahead.
So I don't know if any of you have watched Daredevil on Netflix.
No.
Nope.
I have.
Yes. I'm glad that two people. All right, see, England has watched it, and you fucking haven't watched it, you redhead son of a bitch.
England's ahead of us in time. Of course they've watched it before I have.
They're a decade ahead of us.
It's 6 hours in advance.
Do you have the Powerball numbers?
Jeez. Well, so they've been releasing all details for the next Daredevil season. Jessica Jones just finished filming, and Luke Cage is finally casting.
Oh, right.
So they've... it's been a while, so I forgot to actually like look up names and shit. And the one dude's name is crazy long. He was on the 4400.
That's a silly name.
It is. It's a really... He's black.
Is it like that name in Family Guy? Oh. Remember, at the end credits, there's a last name that's like 40 characters.
Insane.
Unbelievable.
But Rosario Dawson is basically the fucking star of the Netflix MCU. She's going to be in every fucking season.
That's why I'm not watching that.
Interesting.
That what?
I love Rosario Dawson.
And she's amazing, so watch it.
No.
I wouldn't so badly show my mic in your ass.
Logic is flawless.
Probably not the only thing.
Well, before we continue, let me say, thank you to the fangirl and Dystopian for bringing the donuts today. That is very much appreciated. Thank you, guys.
I give you guys high fives, but
that was my contribution.
And what kind of donuts are they?
They are
apple crisp
cake donuts and pumpkin caked pumpkin iced cake donuts.
Oh, that is God. Way too fat for me.
Pumpkin glaze.
I think one donut is your calorie intake for one day.
Can I just have a burger?
Anything else you want to touch on before we get into the trailers?
How did we get?
Danny, come here.
No.
No, not touch, just touch on.
Not at the moment, no.
All right.
I don't think so.
Well, with that being said, we're going to hop right into the trailers. Our first one being Everest.
I got to ask the question, you know I do. Why? I have kids. They see a regular guy can follow impossible dreams. Maybe they'll do the same.
I'm on the top of Everest, Alan. We made it. All right, guys. Time to go home. Looking good, Ben. Looking good.
So, the director of this is Baldistar...
Balthazar?
Yeah, Balthazar!
Balthazar! Balding Star!
Balthazar Kurmakor. Now, he's an Icelandic director.
McGregor!
McGregor!
Boulder Corncob?
It is I, Big McLarge Huge.
Big McLarge Huge.
Oh, dear.
No. I gotta give my hats off to you, mate, for even trying to pronounce his name.
Oh, I know.
That's a good one, man.
Yeah. Now, he's an Icelandic director, mostly directed Scandinavian films, but he has directed a few American films.
Is he hot?
No, he's from Iceland.
I know.
He's
I
from
like
Iceland.
I like Norwegian guys.
Apparently.
He's directed Contraband, if you remember that, with Mark Wahlberg, as well as Two Guns, which came out, I think, 1 or 2 years ago with...
Mark Wahlberg.
Wasn't it Denzel Washington?
Was it Denzel and Mark Wahlberg? Wasn't it?
Denzel and Mark Wahlberg can both be in the same
Ryan Reynolds,
movie.
Wasn't it?
That would break
was that Ryan Reynolds?
No. Not all white people
right.
look the same.
Was with Mark Wahlberg, my bad, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, no, I
so he likes Mark
I saw
Wahlberg.
Contraband. Contraband was okay, but I never saw Two Guns.
I watched the beginning of Two Guns. It wasn't fantastic, but it was that like cheesy action kind of.
It was really difficult because there were only two guns, and they just had to keep passing them around.
There's three of us.
Why? This isn't working.
There was like an entire terrorist group, and they were like, "Can we borrow one of your guns?"
Like, it's out of
ammo.
Math.
Fuck.
Fair enough.
What are you doing?
Nothing. Don't worry about it.
You're freaking out. You're having a seizure. I gotta know if you're dying.
Punch him in the face by accident.
So, yeah, by accident. In this film, yeah. We have a massive cast. We have Jason Clarke, who was recently in Terminator Genesis.
Awesome.
As well as Zero Dark Thirty, who was in Public Enemies as well. We have Keira Knightley. We have Sam Worthington. We have Jake Gyllenhaal.
Sam Worthington, who was also in a Terminator movie.
We have Josh Brolin. We have...
Love Josh Brolin.
John Hawkes, who is in Winter's Bone and Deadwood.
And Identity.
And Identity, right. We have Robin Wright, who is currently in House of Cards. We have Emily Watson, who you know from...
Minority Report.
Yeah, Minority Report, Equilibrium, and Red Dragon.
Equilibrium!
And,
I also love it when I don't fall over.
Holy crap, an amazing cast behind this, I gotta say.
Yeah, this
now, this is based around the events of the 1996 Everest disaster. Which...
What year? I'm sorry.
So that means that Nick is gonna review this movie, and he's gonna tell us if it was accurate.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. It's
not your decision. Nick has his own mind. He can figure it out himself.
All right.
I got to say one thing about this movie. It was so much bad luck that it started releasing trailers right when the Nepal earthquake thing happened this year.
Oh, I know. Yeah. That is just such bad luck.
I mean, if we stopped releasing movies every time...
My brother
was
actually at base camp at the
really?
Time of the quake. Wow. Yeah, he was. Fortunately, he was already heading down the mountain 8 hours before the earthquake actually happened. But I remember like a day after it happened, and I got the call, and he was absolutely fine. And I was just a little bit unsettled, so I take my sister and we go off to the cinema to kind of, you know, relax the nerves. And what fucking trailer did we see pop up?
Oh, wow.
This movie.
Fuck you!
Wow. It was trying to, move on and, not think about bloody Everest. And then the movie
collapsed. Oh, my God.
Actually, a friend of mine from high school was also at base camp at the time of the Nepal earthquakes as well. And
6 degrees of the world.
Yeah, and she, they couldn't get in contact with her for over a week. I think it was. And everyone was freaking out. Like, all the Hong Kong newspapers were, like, you know, kind of saying, like, you know, help find her, blah, blah, blah. At the end of the day, she was fine. But, yeah, it was, like, a really big deal. She didn't have a phone charger? She didn't have access to a phone. And then, like, all the landlines were, like, all the lines were down and stuff. Mm-hmm. And she just couldn't call home. So... it was like four of them, and they were at base camp as well. So
and then they gotcha. Called her. And they were like, "When are you gonna be home? I'd be there 10 minutes." I'm sorry.
Wow.
Get the hell wow. out. Wow.
I'm trying get to your friend's American out. Though.
You're
hit me. I'm gonna hug her.
The Wonder Twins are about to fight.
Okay. Wait. Was your friend? Was she American?
No, she was. She was from Hong Kong. She's
okay.
So she was Chinese.
Oh, she's Chinese. Yeah. I got to say that the Americans really got their shit together when natural disasters happen. Because I'm serious. Because like when my brother got down the mountain, they go into a bar and he's part of like some sort of a exchange group gap year program.
Okay.
And they're in this bar, and there's suddenly a bunch of, like, he says, Navy SEALs. I think they're just soldiers, like, burst in the room. And they're like, and they go up to his group, and they said, like, are you American? And he's like, no. Okay, who here is an American? And a couple of them put their hands up. It's like, right, we're taking you home. And my brother's like, wait, what about us? It's like, your governments will sort you out, don't worry. And they just leave them there. It's just like, what the fuck?
Wow.
That's something. That's crazy.
That's my mama.
I know, but the fact that like your government was the first on the scene to get Americans out is just on it. Like Britain
well,
was
well,
like
fuck, Nick. We're everywhere now. Like you can't step foot on this planet without us being somewhere.
Yeah, we're everywhere just in case something happens and we need to leave.
Right.
And you learned from Hurricane Katrina, I think.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
We learned something from that.
Yeah, yikes.
Oh, lordy. Well, I'm glad he got out safe. And yeah, when did that occur? Was that late last year?
No, it was this year.
Was it this year?
April 2, 2015.
Right, that's right, yeah. And that actually ties into this trailer a bit. The 1996 disaster was the worst Everest disaster until that occurred. So
yeah, yeah.
It's interesting how you know the events of this are kind of tying into now that current disaster.
So in the next few years, should we be expecting a sequel?
Pretty much.
Everest 2, 2015.
Yes, pretty. Now, I'm going to say, I don't really go in for mountain climbing films. I mean, they're... It's
is it because you can't climb
no,
mountains?
No!
That's a silly thing to say.
Small niche.
I know!
Stay with me. It's a small niche, but it's a very generic niche.
I can think of one film.
What is it?
Yeah. Was it...
Everest.
That was the one with Robin from Batman and Robin.
Chris O'Donnell.
Yeah.
Yes, there's that, and there's Cliffhanger, and there's Alaska, and there's a few others.
127 hours, technically
white,
one.
You're very white, and you reflect.
Yeah, that, okay, no, stop. No, I don't know if that's one or not. That's
no,
that's just a guy being trapped in a ravine.
Okay, yeah. I mean, did he have to climb things before getting trapped?
I don't know.
Okay, so basically we came up with a couple more than we thought. But still, it's not very big.
No, but they all hit the same points of, oh, well, there's people trapped, and then someone has to go and sacrifice themselves on one part of the mountain, and they're not using the right gear, and someone gets trapped in some ice.
They have to eat their best friend. I know.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And they all hit the same points for me. And while they're not necessarily bad films, I'm just like, okay...
Give me something new.
I mean, yeah.
But that's kind of what happens.
In this?
And
no,
all
no,
based
like in
on
real life.
Things.
Like if, yeah, like because these are things that happen, right?
Right, and maybe that's
like maybe if you go mountain hike climbing.
Yeah.
What's the word?
Mountaining.
Climbing.
Mountain jogging.
Hiking sounds a bit more leisurely. Like,
yeah, it does.
Mountain watching.
I'm gonna go mountain strolling.
There's only a certain number of risks that you will encounter. It's not like
true. Like
and
you're
all
not going to
like a yeti.
Yeah,
right.
You're not going to encounter a tornado on the mountain. Hopefully. Although admittedly, that sounds like a great sci-fi film.
I'm thinking Tornado
Mountain
4 on the mountain on Everest. Like, God damn it.
Damn it, sci-fi.
All that being said, I love the cast that's in this. I think it's a phenomenal
ridiculous
cast.
Mm-hmm.
You had mentioned there are some people in here we haven't seen for a while. Sam Worthington is just now getting back into the industry. He almost took like a 2-3 year hiatus. He's coming back into the industry.
Good reason.
Keira Knightley hasn't done a lot for a while.
No, she
I
has.
Doubt she's going to do much in this movie either.
Yeah.
Wife who calls us, I know you'll be fine, and puts the phone down.
Oh, you like Keira Knightley, don't you?
I do.
Karen's a huge Keira Knightley fan, and she's been following her.
I can tell by your face.
No, she's been doing quite a few things, but it's just, independent films and stuff like that.
Right.
I can't remember. There was this one with her, and then she was older, and then she meets this girl, and then she's dating the dad, but then I don't really remember what happened.
That apparently, sounds terrible.
That's true.
It looked good. It
that's the worst
good.
Film I've ever heard of.
It's the way that
there was a door that opened.
And Jack Nicholson?
Sound a little bit like...
Diane Keaton and Jack Nicholson?
Yeah.
What?
Diane like Keaton and Jack
Lifetime
Nicholson.
Lifetime movie.
Yeah.
Are you talking about, like, Something's Gotta Give?
Yeah.
Is that what it was? Yeah. Where he's dating Amanda Peet?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And then he's like,
why do I know that? This guy.
But getting back to Everest.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
What?
We digress. So.
All the time.
I'm going to say, I'm not necessarily looking forward to this, but I think I'd watch it if it was, you know, like a Netflix movie, or, you know, maybe I'd get it for like a Discount Tuesday or something. Yes, Fangirl.
Sorry, I just have to say, she was in The Imitation Game.
Oh, she was in The Imitation Game. That's right.
Yeah.
It's not about that.
Yeah. Mike okay, sorry. We that. Can continue.
No, it's all right.
Begin Again. No, that was another one. That was the one with
Oh, I thought you were telling us to begin again. I'm like, well, fuck you.
I don't know.
Welcome, all ladies right. and gentlemen. Two threading.
15 seconds of silence.
Game on.
Yeah. I mean... I don't know. I just feel like this movie is going to hit a lot of the same points I've seen a lot in these films. And again, there's not a, it's not a huge genre. It's a very particular niche, but I've seen that these points a lot. And I'm just like, okay, what more are you going to do to this? Admittedly, it's the biggest mountain. It's, you know, the biggest, how would I put this?
The biggest mountain?
No, I said the biggest mountain. There's a word I'm looking for.
Budget? This is definitely
yeah, yeah.
See, and that's why I was gonna
film ever made.
Yes,
I kind of get like a Gravity vibe from it. You know, like
absolutely.
How the way it's shot and
I could see that
everything looks huge. Like you have to watch it in the cinema to get like the
that's
full, experience
what I was gonna say is that like this is the kind of movie where I would see it in theaters because it looks like it's gonna be awesome on a ginormous screen.
That's
exactly
yeah.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Like
yeah.
You watch Gravity on a laptop screen and it's kind of lost.
It's weak.
You know,
yeah.
It doesn't have the same impact.
I think that's a fair point. Thank you. I tell you what, if it was in IMAX, you know, or large format theater, yeah, I'd probably go in for that. I think I would check that out.
Go on Tuesday to Cinemark.
Cinemark Tuesdays. That's unofficially right. Sponsored by Cinemark.
Thanks, Cinemark.
Cinemark drop.
We're getting so sued.
Oh.
I meant Cinemank. Cinemank.
Set-a-give.
Set-a-give.
Set-a-give?
Yeah, that's what we used to call when you got us tickets.
Yes, that's true. Sorry, a couple references. Apologize.
Mike used to get us when Mike
set to give tickets.
Yes.
At movies, I've never
heard. Set to give tickets.
Movies redacted.
So, anyone else thoughts on this before we move on?
It
I get yelled at by your boss for sneaking into.
That's
the
not
hell
a thought bed. On this movie.
Yeah,
that's
you can shut the hell up.
No.
Moving on. Topic. Moving on.
Yeah, I don't care about this movie.
Nick, any
I'm
final
sorry.
Thoughts on this?
No, I'm definitely interested to see it. I mean, like, now that I have, like, more of an emotional attachment to it. You know,
right, right.
Based yeah. on my brother's experience. But I think it looks brilliant. And definitely a little bit different than just having lots of superhero movies like we've been having recently. So, you know, this is, like, real adventure right here.
I think the aficionado is about to punch through the screen.
Hey, don't get me wrong, mate. I love superhero movies. I love variety as well, you know?
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
For sure.
Phase 3 is going to have some variety. We'll have Black Panther and Doctor Strange and
but
all
that.
But
I think he meant, like,
yeah.
variety
oh, variety
of
outside of the superhero
movies.
Genre.
Yeah.
I apologize.
Wow.
Just
you
know, like a
but what
movie
about
or...
these superhero movies?
No, we're going to get these. Sorry.
Oh,
sorry
goodness.
About that.
Phase 4 won't have that creative team. And
wait, is there going to be a Phase 4?
Yeah, there's going to be a Phase 4.
About superhero
I thought Phase
movies.
3 was the end.
Why do you look disappointed?
Hell no, it's not going to be the end. They're going to keep going and going and
oh,
going.
Oh, God.
What's the next trailer?
Next trailer. Next one up we have is Scout's Guide to the Zombie Apocalypse.
Carter, the town's deserted.
Dude, look.
What?
The bouncer, he's gone. We should sneak in.
Dude, there's like nobody here.
Don't worry, Mommy. Daddy's here.
Dude, something's wrong with her. Look at her chest.
No, that's makeup, dummy. It's a jungle thing. Oh, my God! Wait, you're the stripper.
Cocktail waitress.
What is going on?
Do you think everyone's eating each other?
Like a...
Any more questions?
So this one kind of looked like Zombieland.
Yes.
It like definitely borrowing points from Zombieland. Yeah, and we're gonna get to that in a second.
It looked
and
like was a that zombie super bad.
Kinda.
Oh, that's a good. That's a pretty good comparison too. Yeah.
Was the stripper? What's her name? Rose McGowan.
No, is that her name? That wasn't Rose McGowan.
No. She's way
Am I
too
thinking
old.
The same person?
No.
Are you thinking? I think.
I'll look
I mean, to be that girl, she's too old to be
let
that
Mike,
girl.
Let Mike talk about it, and then maybe we'll learn her name.
I was thinking hey, the chick from point. Bridesmaids, who was.
Yeah, you can pull that up for me, Danny. If
I'm on it.
Okay, thank Bridesmaids. You. So, the director of this, we have Christopher Landon. He was the screenwriter for Paranormal Activity 2 through 4. Then he directed Paranormal Activity: The Lost Ones, which is admittedly probably the worst Paranormal Activity film.
I enjoy
how you
one
judge
also.
Those. I don't know. They just seem to get generic over and over and over. But
hey, Mike, I think they're all terrible.
Want me to take my dick out?
That's not a
what?
That's
just
not
just
relevant.
For you to suck on something instead of running your mouth because I enjoy those movies.
Wow. Oh, that's where you went. With
you mean
that.
The overly racist why are you still Mark here? Ones?
Yeah.
So in this, we have
I'm super racist.
Ty Sheridan and Logan Miller, who are both in the Stanford Prison Experiment, which we just talked about last week, actually.
Yeah.
That's basically their only real credit as of yet. We have David Koner. Now, he was in Ron Burgundy, Waiting in the Goods. In Ron Burgundy, he was one of
what?
The four...
Oh, Koechner. David Koechner. I was like,
is
who
that
did
what
you
I...
say? Yeah, it's Koechner.
Sorry, Koechner.
It's okay. I didn't understand it at first.
But he was one of the four lead newscasters in Ron Burgundy. He was also in... He was the manager in Waiting, and he was in The Goods, if you remember that.
Oh,
live
yeah.
hard, die yeah. fast.
He's in a lot of stuff. It's
so
just
hard.
That guy you recognize.
He's
him.
Never been, like, the lead in anything.
No,
he
he's never
just,
has.
Like,
no, I thought
that him. Extra. Yeah, I saw him.
I thought you meant... Ron Burgundy, The Goods. I thought that was like one movie. And
yeah.
I was like,
God.
What are you talking
yeah,
about?
A mismatch
like,
there.
Yeah. Okay.
Damn it, Mush Mouth.
Oh, there was a comma there. I also heard that.
Yeah.
I was like, Ron Burgundy, colon, The Goods. And I was
like,
was that a movie?
Yeah, I think that was like a third, like a middle one or something.
And what is the actress's name, Danny?
The Goods is
her name is, where is the back button? Houston Sage.
Oh, I don't fucking know who that is.
And what has she been in?
She has been in, damn it.
The Neighbors?
Internet.
She
was in Neighbors.
Or just Neighbors.
Grown Ups 2.
Wait,
which
Neighbors
is your favorite
is Zac
movie.
Efron movie?
Yeah.
Wait, hold on.
Yeah, she was the girlfriend.
Finally,
oh, yeah,
in this,
that is.
Also from Grown Ups 2, we have Patrick Schwarzenegger. Yes.
Really?
Wait. Are you saying Schwarzenegger's son is in this?
Yes, Schwarzenegger's son is in this.
Wow.
Is he the fat one?
No, he's not the fat one.
Damn, that would have been hilarious.
You know Schwarzenegger would not let his boy be fat.
That's why I was hoping. Schwarzenegger was fat for a while.
Yeah, and to look at the kid, he looks a bit like Schwarzenegger. I mean, he's still young, but give him a look. It's like, wow, he definitely has the facial structure of Schwarzenegger.
You bringing that shit up, Danny?
Of course.
Pull up a picture of him.
This is my job. That's why they pay me the big bucks. Okay, I see it. I mean, he's a pretty boy, but...
Wait, you get paid for
it? Does he have his dad's funky accent? That's what I want to know.
I don't... That's a good question.
Give him the job.
He's really pretty.
I know, he's a pretty guy.
He's pretty.
Schwarzenegger was pretty. Well, Schwarzenegger was pretty when he was younger too.
He was alright.
To be fair, you have to judge. You can't judge it by 2015.
No,
standards.
I'm not. I'm thinking of like his face and like his old. Like,
and that's the thing. He was pretty when he was young.
By their standards, I'm with Danny
that's
on this.
See, thank
okay,
you.
Okay,
I'm with Cam.
Thank you. We judge guys. Thanks.
But yes, the only film this Schwarzenegger's been in is Grown Ups 2, which is not a very good.
I haven't seen any of those
have
movies.
On your.
So basically, he was probably one of the frat boys in Grown Ups.
He was
too.
One of the frat boys, yeah. But he's in this. And my first reaction to this is exactly the reaction that the Black Lantern had, which is, this looks like a sci-fi movie.
Oh,
this
yeah,
looks
absolutely.
Like something you would see on, you know, an afternoon on the Sci-Fi Channel, just like Z Nation.
You're
just
bored, like, you don't have anything to do.
The slapstick zombie humor.
You're just like, ah, it was funny.
Yeah, and also comparing it to Zombieland. It's very much in that vein as well. That all being said, I mean, there's not too much to break down about this. It's a couple boys who are somehow, are they Eagle Scouts at this point? Because they're at the age where they should
scouts.
Be Eagle Scouts.
Yeah, they are like 16.
Yeah, but yet they're still going out and
they're getting
wanna...
like entire heads of lettuce thrown at them in the hallway at school.
Right.
I was confused why that person had an entire head of lettuce.
Just to throw at them. They just brought it to school to throw at them.
But I need a fresh head of lettuce. No, this is for assault.
wait. You guys have Scouts for 16-year-olds?
Yeah, when it gets to that age, it's called Eagle Scouts. It's basically the highest branch you could be in Boy Scouts. And then past that...
And still not get laid.
Yeah, and still not get laid.
Yeah, it's
I
basically what
surprised.
You do when you still don't
have friends. You have other things to do apart from learning how to why not? Shit.
Like, masturbate?
Oh, wow. Yeah.
There's a badge for that, don't worry.
No wonder they're being, punched in the face or whatever in the movie, you know, being bullied and stuff.
Although, you know what?
No wonder.
You know what? He does. He ties the knot for her purse, and I'm like, he's like, this will never come undone. And I'm like, this is a good intro to a horror movie. Like, I'll just tie you to a bed. You're not getting the fuck out.
Yeah, this is a super Windsor double knot. Right. You're not getting out of this.
There needs to be like a sci-fi version of this, like kidnapped by Boy Scouts.
Oh, God.
Like, I'm never getting out. Do you see this?
It could be taken in a lot of different ways.
Yes, it can.
It could be taken.
We are digressing in so many different directions right now.
I did it on purpose.
Because you brought a lot of us together.
Yeah. I don't know how I feel about this. I mean, I'm all for the fun zombie film.
I hate zombie movies so much. I'm so fucking bored by them.
I know you are, but for the rest of us who have fun
with
them.
We didn't really ask, but that's
what do you guys think of this?
I don't think he's asking.
I'm not going to see this in theaters, I don't think, unless somebody says it was the best movie of all time.
Which I don't think is going to happen.
Which I don't think anybody's going to say.
If they tell you that, do not trust them.
They have had way too many drugs.
Probably working for the studio.
I will definitely watch it when it comes on TV, but it's not new about it.
Right.
It's the same.
It's kind of just a rehashing.
Except with Boy Scouts.
I enjoyed Zombieland, even though I don't like zombie movies, because it had that fun camp and whatever, but this just looks boring. It doesn't look like it's going to bring anything new to the table.
No. Nope.
Yeah, I'm with you on that.
Except for cats. Zombie cats.
Yeah, zombie cats.
That was the best part of that trailer.
I'm scared of cats in general.
Puppet cat just like leaning over his shoulder.
It kind of gave me this vibe. There's a New Zealand movie called Black Sheep. Where all the sheep in New Zealand start eating people.
Love that fucking movie.
Just like, they're just like sheep throughout the entire movie. Like that was quite fun.
Yes.
Nice. I have been confused by that before because there's a movie in America called Black Sheep that came out in like 96. And every time I see Black Sheep on TV, I'm like, all right. And it's supposed to be a Chris Farley movie. No, it's that fucking New Zealand movie.
It's about zombie sheep. They're just running around biting. Or no, they're not zombies. Well, they kind of are. They bite people and then they turn you into like a were-sheep.
I want to see this movie.
Did
they steal us from Wallace and Gromit?
That's exactly what I was thinking of.
It's a really, really stupid fucking movie, but it's fantastic.
There's a genius shot in it when they're like, run, it's the sheep. And the camera pans, and you just see like some normal sheep. We're like, man.
Oh, that sounds great.
It's wonderful.
They're just eating grass and shit.
I'm really surprised that no one here has seen this movie except for me and Danny has seen parts.
Wow, that sounds amazing.
I'm never the person.
They're just like eating grass and shit.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry to like divert the conversation away from this trailer.
No, that's fine because that sounds like a far better movie than this.
It kind of has nods to like Shaun of the Dead.
Yeah.
Kind of has like nods to this, like the humor style.
Right. Yeah, I agree with that.
Like they could probably do a remake of that movie.
An American remake, you mean?
No, well, Shaun of the Dead. So it'd still be.
Shaun of the. I thought you were still talking about Black Sheep.
Yeah, but Shaun of the Dead could make a remake of it. The Shaun of the Dead people.
Like. Simon Pegg.
Yeah.
Call them by their names. Don't call them the Shaun of the Dead.
I am tired and drinking.
The Shaun of the Dead will make a remake.
Okay.
What's it going to be called? The Shaun of the Black Sheep.
Of the Black Sheep.
Because he's made a lot more than Shaun of the Dead.
The Hot Fuzz Shaun of the Black Sheep.
And then that other movie.
Okay.
Beyond.
World End.
But more importantly, Shaun the Sheep is having a new movie by Aardman Productions, and that makes me really happy.
Yes.
Oh, boy.
So, anyway, we digress.
So, let's go back to the next trailer that I was super bored.
Hold on. Let's finish up with this one real quick.
Okay.
Just going to say, with the cast that they have, it's a very no-name cast with the exception of David.
Exactly.
Yeah. That guy.
It's the guy from Workaholics, I think, is in it, right?
Oh, yeah, Blake. I did see his face for a second.
Blake's in there.
Yeah, Blake.
I hate him.
Why?
Because he has a giant Jufro and he makes me uncomfortable.
Seth Rogen had a giant Jufro.
And that made me uncomfortable too. But the guy from Workaholics who's in Pitch Perfect who played Bumper, he's a little bit cute.
That's Adam...
Something.
Adam... I know their first name. Demand.
Yeah.
Demand.
Yeah.
His last name is Demand.
Yeah.
That's awesome. I would have changed my last name to Demand.
Yes.
He's a little bit more well-known, I think.
Yeah, oh, he definitely some is. Some of the other people. Is he like the troop leader in this? It's hard to tell.
Oh, man, I hope so. With that hair.
He was just kind of in, like, one frame where he was screaming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I couldn't really tell what he was doing.
Must be the troop leader. But yeah, some of the jokes really fell flat for me, like the whole the guy taking the selfie and then the joke about the bomb and the Taliban. I'm like, this isn't funny.
I did like when they were about to run over, I guess, the teacher, the guy from Talladega Nights and all that.
Yeah.
And he's like, he looks awful. Oh, I did light him on fire. What? Yeah. He tried to eat me.
Yeah.
But the way he delivered that line was pretty good.
Yeah. Apart from that, no, I don't think I'm going to be seeing this. Like nope. Around Halloween, you know, if it's just a fun slapstick movie on TV, I might see it. But
apart it comes out at Halloween.
Yeah, it comes out on Halloween this year. I mean, I just don't know if I'd go out of my way to see this. That's all.
No.
Right there with you.
Maybe if I need, like, an empty movie theater to go do dirty things in, I'll pay to get into this.
And movie. Moving on.
Next trailer.
Our next trailer is...
What? I support the arts.
The 33.
That's a big rock.
That's not a rock. That's the heart of the mountain. She finally broke.
And I...
33 men trapped underground. And we don't even know if they're alive.
We all know how this goes. The government tells us how much they care, and they do nothing.
It was over my head.
How long do they have?
There's food and water for 3 days. At all.
I knew this place was dangerous.
Nobody's blaming you.
You are my brother. We gotta pull together. Get out of here. Say
something. Three platforms are now in place, specialized in deep drilling.
Say that one better.
A huge rock, twice the size of the Empire State Building, shifted.
We're running out of time.
It's not a question of if it falls, but when.
I'm not leaving without him.
If that is our last supper,
I quit.
Like, you made the big point about Everest, where like they're all kind of the same. Like all of the people got buried alive. Like yes, shit happened. That happens, and when it's on the news, I'm like, oh my god, this is. So upsetting, but when it's in a movie, I'm like, I get it. You're buried. They save you. One of your friends died. I'm sorry. Okay.
Well, it's not just about that.
Every film has that same thing, you know?
I know.
Like, we
I
like to watch some stuff that we're familiar with. This is a film about triumph of the human spirit.
Agreed.
You know,
yeah.
Triumph has a great burger. I was telling you about it.
Anyway. But yeah, I'm going to say, I get what you're saying, Paul, but... This is much more than just that. It's also about the politics, what was going on. Because the Chilean government was at that time just saying, oh, well, you know, these men are a dime a dozen. Who cares about us spending $20 million to get them out? You know, they just didn't care. Yes, Fangirl.
I would have liked it if they did not speak in English.
That
would have been better.
Yeah, that's true.
That would not get an international release.
That's true, though.
I mean, I would love it as a Brit because I love watching everything with subtitles, but the average American doesn't truly care about that.
Yeah, a lot of people would see that. You're right. Like, I'm not going to go watch that. Yeah. I have to read, which is sad.
It's sad. Like, that's the thing. Yeah. Just, like, I would have rathered it be
all
because.
My friends hate me.
Yeah, well, you get the hell out.
I will say this, though. I wish that they cast more Hispanic people to play these fucking
roles. Yes,
rather than was it Gabriel Byrne, who's like Irish or something?
Right?
I mean, it's like weird that like the only really Hispanic role has to go to like Antonio Banderas.
Antonio Banderas.
Spanish. He's not even like Chilean or like Mexican or whatever. You know, he's more European than anything else.
He's Puss in Boots.
Of course, yes.
So the director of this is Patricia Regan. Now, she is a Mexican director. This is actually her first major English release, but she's had some mild success in Latin America and South America. In this, we have Antonio Banderas, as we mentioned. We have Juliette Binoche. Is that how you pronounce her name? She was in The English Patient and Chocolat.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I know her, but...
Was she the lead in Chocolat?
I think she's the lead, yeah. She was also...
She was good in that.
Yeah, and I think she won the Academy for English Patient. Nice. Pretty sure she did. We also have Lou Diamond Phillips.
Yeah, I
haven't seen him in forever.
Yeah, that totally threw me.
I know, I'm a little bit confused about that one.
Just a little.
Hey, La Bamba.
I think that's the last movie he did.
I don't think Stargate Universe did him any favors.
No.
Yeah.
He's been in a lot of terrible sci-fi movies. Yeah. Channel movies.
He was in Stand and Deliver a while back. That was the only other thing I know notable.
Wasn't that the 80s too?
No, that was a little bit. I think that was in the 2000s.
Really?
Yeah.
He was in Stand By Me.
He was in a show with Jason Momoa recently.
Yeah. I forget what that was.
Recent, but he was in Young Guns.
Oh, yeah, he was in Young Guns. That's right. We also have Ariana Barriaza, and she was in Babel, and recently she was in Drag Me to Hell, which is actually a pretty good movie. She was she was like the old witch crony
woman.
who curses the old girl.
Okay.
And she's a good actress. I think she won a lot of awards for Babel. But yes, this is based around the 2010 Chilean mining disaster, which trapped 33 men underground for more than 2 months. I still remember, you know, I was working at the DMV at the time, and I still remember, you know, that was, of all things, I mean, it's a sad statement, that was like our soap opera. You know, you'd go back into the room, and you would just sit there and watch this drama unfolding. Mm-hmm. And the whole world was captivated by this. And it's a sad statement that if it hadn't been for these families, if it hadn't been for people, you know, crying out, we may have never known about this. Because it wasn't just the company that was trying to cover it up. The government was like, look, we don't need this negative press about how terrible these mining conditions are. I hope this movie dives into that a bit. I mean, it's great that they're diving in, you know, to this, you know, the strife and the conditions of what these men went through, because of course that's an important point. But it's also just as important as the actions above ground is what led to this. Because again, without those actions, none of this would have occurred. They would have just left them down there. Mm-hmm. Right. So that's just equally as important in my mind. Mm-hmm. So all that being said, what are your guys' thoughts on this trailer, this upcoming movie?
I'm terribly excited. I love these kind of movies. It's like the underdog, you know, going up against the governments and the corporations who are trying to keep it all quiet. It's kind of like Aaron Brockovich in a way, yes. You know, where it has a state of hopelessness. And I think that because of this movie, they're definitely going to fix all their public safety that they have completely disregarded, which right. led to the mining disaster in the first place.
Right. Aaron Brockovich is an interesting comparison to this.
No, I mean, like, this like the general status quo, like the trailer where he's saying, like, my responsibilities are the lives of all these men, and they just couldn't give a shit, you know, right. You're supposed to meet your quota for the day.
That's the truth, yeah.
And it takes something big in order to shock it all, and the fact that they were ready to cover this all up to begin with, until, like, the press came in and all of that, like, that just, I just see that with Aaron Brockovich.
Yeah, and I think that's fair. I will say, the few of the leads they have in this, Banderas and Juliet, I think it's going to be performed very well.
Yeah.
Banderas looks great in it. I'm just going to say that. I think he's pulling off a great character in this. When was the last thing Banderas was in? I can't recall the last thing he was in.
Puss in Boots.
Yeah. But besides yeah. Puss in Boots.
He was in that Dystopia movie. Wasn't
oh,
he?
Yeah.
Oh,
that
Automata. About. Automata, yeah.
Automata. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I never saw Automata.
Could never remember the name of that.
Yeah. But yeah, I'm very much looking forward to this.
He was also in the SpongeBob.
Oh, the SpongeBob movie. Yeah.
Oh, I love the Scum-Cum movie.
Poor man.
It was an Expendables 3. Oh my god.
Oh yeah.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Yep.
I still need to see that.
So good.
No, you don't. Go see.
I really want to see it.
Don't listen to the Brit.
Nick,
go
she
see
is
it.
A huge nerd for the Expendables film.
Go see it now. Oh, you're obviously not that big of a nerd if you didn't see the third one.
Just watch Desperado again.
Yeah, watch Desperado, which
I will watch.
But I'm not seeing it for Antonio Banderas. I'm seeing it for like everybody else.
Shit blowing up.
Yeah.
Amazing.
What? Yeah, I'm hoping they do cover the politics above ground, like you were saying.
Yeah.
That's pretty much the only thing that would get me to want to see it, because we already know the gist of the mining part of it. But
And that's something that's actually an apt thing to bring up. A lot of these films that are coming out as of late, especially, you know, we talk about it in Everest, and now with this is in recent history. A lot of people know the events of this, you know? Mm-hmm. It's not like taking the events of something that occurred in the 1920s or 1930s that maybe was, you know, an important event in that time,
yeah.
But it's kind of been lost in obscurity since then.
Right.
This occurred 5 years ago. Most people know how this transpired. And while it's interesting to see what happened to these, you know, to men buried below ground, and we didn't really see that happening live, of course, but it's going to be dramatized, and it's not going to be exactly how it happened in how that's transpired in Chile. So, I don't know.
And those guys are going to be super upset. They'd be sitting there like, I never even fucking talked about that. Like, we didn't even
well, I mean,
have
that's
that
the case with every historical movie.
Right, that's true.
But wait till
it's just
dead.
Supposed to give you a general idea, and then if you're interested enough, then you can go and research about it. Or you can watch History Bus, which is like a general pleasure.
Yeah. There you go.
Boom, got him.
Sorry. Lame.
It's all right, no worries. All that being said, yes, I think I'm looking forward to this.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Cinemark Tuesdays, baby.
I mean, like, we know... just because we know what's going to happen doesn't mean that we shouldn't watch. I mean, like, we all knew the fucking Titanic would sink, you know, in that movie. What? Look how many people watched that.
Like, well, seven.
Wait, hold on. The Titanic sank?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Nick, I'm going to cut you off there. Some people didn't know the Titanic sank when they went in.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, my.
I know.
Spoiler alert.
You know, that is one I hope you examine, because growing up, I was a huge fan of shipwrecks in general.
You were swallowed.
Are you okay?
No. Like, the exploring of shipwrecks. Not is this like Unbreakable?
Oh, my God. You got to clarify.
Fuck. I loved watching shit sink and just all the people screaming.
No, the exploration of shipwrecks.
Women and children,
Mommy, they're drowning.
God.
Mom,
no.
Isn't it amazing? It's beauty. It's nature, Mom. I can't wait for this movie.
No, for the love of God. Like, I read up on...
Is that who you think makes shipwrecks?
I read up on the exploration of ships like the Bismarck and the Vasa and the Diatocha, you know, ships that sank, famous ships, and how they found them and how they explored them.
Okay.
That's found them in submarines. It is pretty amazing.
Maybe you could be a guest host when he does the Titanic.
Yeah, we are for that.
But when you talk about how you love shipwrecks, specify the exploration and not the shipwrecking.
Right.
I love it when
shit goes terrible.
Yeah, but I know we're getting off topic here, but in that movie, they ruined so many characters, like the character of the unsinkable Molly Brown. In historical context, she was a great character. She saved dozens of lives. In the movie, she says, oh, we have to go save them. And then some shipmates like tells her to fuck off, and she does nothing. Why would you call her the unsinkable Molly Brown if she just sits there and does diddly shit?
Because she's fucking Kathy Bates, and she's God.
That's true. She was in Misery.
Yeah.
No, I love Kathy Bates, but they gave her nothing to do.
It was all off panel. It was like Squirrel Girl.
Yeah.
It was all off panel.
She was in Waterboy.
She was also in Waterboy.
Not to mention that, like, the first officer up and shoots someone and then shoots himself when it's been proven that he saved possibly hundreds of lives on the ship. He wasn't off killing people and then shooting himself in the head.
He killed one person, not people. Person.
People's the plural.
You get my
person.
Point.
Right.
You get my point.
Okay.
Yeah. But anyway.
Breathe, man.
Now that
breathe.
You've gotten that
out. I got out of my system. I apologize.
You should really come on history.
Appa had to come over. Appa had to come over and call him. He's like, Uncle Mike seems upset. Let me sit here so he can rub my neck.
Yeah, Nick, I'm currently petting Appa. He's calming my nerves.
Appa's a dog.
Yeah.
In case people didn't catch that.
Oh, yeah, Nick, it wasn't really Appa. Clearly explained. Appa is my 5-year-old Shiba Inu. He is, a very opinionated dog, but clearly knows when he's needed.
Much cute.
Thank you.
Much comes cute, very pretty.
What's that?
I said much cute, very pretty.
Much cute, very pretty. Wow. Very pet. Hey. Much stress.
Anyway, moving on to our next trailer, which is...
No, Mike, don't stop.
The Night Before.
Gentlemen, 14 years ago to this very night, I lost my parents. You guys have been with me every single Christmas since then.
You knew.
But tonight, we have decided to end this tradition. Chris is just too famous to hang out with us anymore. And Isaac's about to have a baby.
You have been such a rock throughout this whole pregnancy. Tonight, just focus on yourself.
Whoa. Dreams? Is this cocaine? You haven't done cocaine for 11 years, I don't think.
Yeah, no one has, I don't think.
Holy...
I have a present for you. We're going to the best Christmas party in New York City. So that gives us several hours to hit as many traditions as possible.
Just right off the bat, this looks like a blast.
Yeah.
Hold on, wait, I don't remember which one this one was.
The Night
Joseph,
Before?
Joseph,
oh, this, yes.
It.
The one you guys were laughing your asses off about.
I remember enjoying it, but I don't remember the trailer. Yes, this one actually looked really good. And I don't usually like the Seth Rogen super movies.
Neither do I.
But this one looks really good.
Yeah, I don't like Seth Rogen very much.
You don't like Seth Rogen?
I will only watch something with James Franco in it because I assume his boyfriend will be in it.
I'm going to assume James Franco shows up in this at some point.
Without a doubt.
But directing this, we have Jonathan Levine. Now, he was the director of Warm Bodies, which was a very pleasant surprise. I liked that movie.
I did enjoy that movie a lot. And the guy from the other zombie movie was in that. Wait, no, I was thinking of the wrong bald guy. Never mind, move on. Some other white bald guy.
Sorry. As well as Rush, which The Goddess and I saw a while back. That was the...
The Joseph Gordon-Levitt
JGL,
one?
Which... Who's
like
in
the
this?
Bike one?
No.
That, Rush was that's the race car
Rush.
Driving.
Yeah,
right?
that was.
Yeah, I saw
Chris
the bike
Hemsworth.
Movie.
And,
I know, I saw that one.
Yeah,
maybe
that was the bike movie with Taylor Lautner in it.
Yeah, no, Rush was about F1 racing in the 1970s.
Mm-hmm. F2.
But that was actually a very good film. So this director's got some good stuff behind
him. I never heard of it.
In this, we have Joseph Gordon-Levitt. We have Seth Rogen. We have Anthony Mackie, who is Falcon, right?
Yes.
Yep. And I'm super excited for that. I mean, you know, not for anything Avengers related.
Uh-huh. We have Lizzie Chaplin, and I love Lizzie Chaplin. Oh, I think she's great. We have Jillian Bell, who has been in Workaholics as well as 22 Jump Street recently.
Yeah, she's hilarious. Yeah.
She's pretty good.
She's so funny.
Yes.
Lizzie Chaplin was in The Avengers.
Okay, thank you.
Lizzie Chaplin?
We also have Mindy Kaling. We have Jason Jones, who is most well-known from being a correspondent on The Daily Show. And we have Miley Cyrus as herself.
Yes.
Look. Pre-nipple tassels?
No, I don't know.
Because I kind of don't hate her as a person. I just hate when I have to look at her.
Nah. And finally, we have Kanye West.
As himself?
I don't know if he's himself or not. He's just listed.
Of course
in
he is. It's the only person he can be.
No, he's playing Jesus. That's what he's playing.
No, he's a gay fish.
He's a gay fish.
He's a motherfucker. Cake.
This takes place in 2020. He's the president.
He's just gonna like break. Up. He's gonna break characters. And be like, I'm not a gay fish. I'm the president. Oh, he died. What's going on?
The premise of this film is that it's three guys who are, you know, having a last go on this tradition they've had for like 14, 15 years. When one guy's parents passed away, and then they would spend Christmas night together, and they're having one last fling, and they're getting hopped up on shrooms and
I've had those nights.
Cocaine and. Cool. Vomiting in churches and
yeah. Seth Rogen's wife gives that to him. I was like, that's the
yeah, Jillian Bell. Right,
she's a great wife.
Yeah, she's pregnant. She's just like, oh, you've been a rock through this whole pregnancy. So have a night out to yourself. Just gives him this box with. It's like the box from Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Just all these drugs that are in there. A quart of tequila, a quart of rum, a stream of uppers, downers, laughers.
Steve went for surgery. And he's like, they gave me some really great painkillers, and I was like, and you brought some for me, right? Yeah. He's like, no, I used them. I was in pain. I was like, you couldn't ask for more? For what?
They're for pain.
Yeah,
are you in pain?
Always.
Anyway, so I saw this, and the first thought I had was like, you know, this is kind of like a At World's End combined with Pineapple Express combined with A Christmas Story. You know, it's just, no, I know, stay with me. It's, you know, the guy's going out having one last thing, having a great time, which is, you know, a little bit of At World's End. Of course, not with the whole robots and whatever, but Pineapple Express because you got a ton of drugs. And then A Christmas Story, because that takes place at Christmas, even though the lead character is Jewish. What are your guys' thoughts on this? I think this looks like pretty much, this looks pretty fun.
I'm going to see it. It looks freaking hilarious.
I'll probably, my boyfriend won't see it, so I'll just go with Danny.
Okay. Dystopian? If you were feeling better, you'd want to see this, right?
Don't tell me how to live. I don't know. I might see it if it was like a group of us going or something, but it's not something I would seek out. Like, oh, I'm going to definitely watch this.
Hey, well, Danny and I are going to go see this movie. You want to go?
On a Tuesday.
On a Tuesday?
My thing is, each year you get a couple of these Christmas-themed films. You know, they're just kind of toss-away films. You know, we've had stuff, you know, like Deck the Halls.
Jingle All the Way?
No, well, that's Jingle All the Way back.
Oh, wait.
Now, I was going to say,
Jingle
like...
Jingle All the Way was awesome.
Yeah.
I know.
Four Christmases.
I wasn't knocking it. I like it.
It wasn't a throwaway.
Fred Claus. Fred Claus.
Christmas with the Cranks.
No. Jingle All the Way is not a throwaway film. Yeah. Sorry.
Eight Crazy Nights, Jingle All the Way.
Oh, those God. Eight Crazy Nights was garbage. Oh, my God.
Are you insane? Eight Crazy Nights is amazing. It's the last Adam Sandler thing I thought was decent.
I think Adam Sandler's probably the best director in Hollywood. But
you,
I mean,
need
that's
to stop. You need to stop.
Danny almost got thrown out of the house. God damn it.
Here's a question. Is it going to be R-rated?
I would assume it would.
Fingers crossed, yeah,
that's,
Danny.
That's alone.
There's coke
cool
in the trailer. I assume it's going to be R-rated.
Yeah. Right. I mean, I couldn't find a Red Band trailer for this, but I'm going to assume that's going to be rated R.
Yeah, it wasn't very not Red Band, though, with the cocaine.
Yeah. Exactly. Usually they're like, oh, I got you a gift. Is it drugs? Something is poorly dubbed.
Candy.
Is it candy?
Is it a sandwich?
It's peppermints.
Yeah, it's Warner's funny. Like original. When she opens the box, I'm like, is it going to be weed? If it's weed, then it's very tame. That could be PG-13. But the fact that it's like cocaine and shrooms and like, well, ecstasy and all of that is like, oh, now it's like, you know, all right.
I do like the one joke.
This is adult drugs.
Yeah, I do like the one joke. He's like, is this cocaine? He's like, I haven't done this in 13 years. Like, I don't think anyone's done this in 13 years.
Nobody's done this since Whitney Houston.
No, it's been a while for her. We're fine.
Oh. Yeah.
She's been clean for a few years now.
Holy shit.
Wow.
Anyway, but like I was saying, there's a couple of these each year, just these, you know, one-off Christmas films, and they can be fun. For the most part, they're just kind of generic. There's not a whole lot to do with them. You know, like I mentioned last year, there's Four Christmases and Christmas with the Cranks and all those, and they're just kind of
Love Christmas with the Cranks.
One-offs. But this, I think, looks a bit better than those. I think I could have a blast with this. Nick, any thoughts?
Yeah, I'll definitely be watching. I just love all the kind of Seth Rogen, Judd Apatow movies. I know he's not doing this one.
Right.
But it's the same sort of humor.
Oh, definitely.
Perfectly honest, I'm not a big fan of those sappy sort of Christmas movies, because if you don't do it right, it just comes across as awful. But this sounds like it's a fun time. It just happens to take place on Christmas.
So. Yeah.
I feel like when I saw this film, maybe it was just, I was coming in from a different perspective. I thought it looked like a sappy Christmas film.
Really?
Yes! Oh my gosh, it's like, you know, three bros getting together, you know, having their one last hurrah before, you know, this one as a kid and the other one's too famous or what, I don't know.
You're allowed to say bros, you're a girl.
Why can't she say bros?
She's not bros.
Because she's black.
She thought it was a sappy movie.
I did.
Bro movies aren't sappy.
Yeah, they are. Oh my goodness, they are.
From their genre.
They are. Like, I thought it looked super cute despite, you know, the...
Super cute?
It did. It did look super cute.
Look, they're bonding.
I know. I mean, that's what I want to see it because
he's trying to help him in the one scene get by because he clearly had too many drugs.
He came in like a wrecking ball.
That's
okay, when we were cuddling.
Danny and I were cuddling at that point. But fucking, that's the one thing about this trailer I didn't like, actually. I really, really fucking hate that actress. Mindy, what's her face?
Mindy Kaling?
I think that she is like the least funny person I've ever seen on television.
Really?
I don't mind her. I don't think she's funny at all. I didn't think she deserved the show.
She is a good voice actress. She's done voice acting for Inside Out and something else recently. She is a very good voice actress.
Okay, well, so maybe, and I'm gonna relate this to a white person because I don't want to sound racist.
By doing that, it sounds racist.
Already is racist.
Shut up! I'm not the one time. No,
the
like,
one time.
Brian, the one time I'm not being racist. No, like Brian Regan, I think is really funny as long as I don't have to see his face. So maybe
that's a good point. He's a funny looking guy, but he's really freaking funny.
If you
just listen to him,
yeah, he's
really funny.
But he's if you watch him, it takes away from it kind of. I really think she's an awful actress. I really don't think she's funny. I hated her show. She was on The Office, right?
Mm-hmm.
I hated her on The Office. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was a comedy, and I kept being like, can she get killed off? Like, she's the least funny person on this show.
Oh, that's a shame.
Can she get a new job, I guess? And then, if I heard her as a voice actress and didn't know it was her, I might enjoy it, but I...
Did you see Inside Out?
I haven't seen it yet.
Go see Inside Out. I think you'll like her.
Which one was C-Show?
She was disgusting.
Don't tell him.
Sorry.
Now he's going to know who to look for.
And then he's going to judge
like he doesn't have the internet.
Right.
He might have been too lazy to actually look
that. You can't do things like that on the internet. Like, the internet's for porn.
You can't say that on television.
For porn.
Can you do other things on the internet? I don't think.
Anyway, yes, I'm looking forward to this. It looks like fun, and I think I might go out of my way to see. This is one of the few like Seth Rogen bro films I might go out of my way to see. I think
it comes out around Christmas.
On a Tuesday. It comes out late November, probably around Thanksgiving.
Yeah,
I feel like we should
be one of those
ad readings.
People go.
Like, would you see this on a Tuesday? Would you Redbox this? Are you waiting for it on cable?
We have
that. Or like it's and after Thanksgiving.
It's threading or dreading.
For Christmas.
If you're threading the film, you're looking forward to it. If it's dreading,
except not like with the kids.
He's saying like there needs to be different levels of that.
I just thought it was a funny thing to say. Stop yelling at me, God.
Go home.
Because like sometimes we are looking forward to it, but on a Tuesday, like we wouldn't see it like full price.
Right.
All
right.
Fair enough.
Like if it's like an IMAX movie,
that is not worth $15 of my money.
Exactly.
Okay, like, that's fair.
There are movies that I want to see, but then I'm like, I'm going to wait until it's on Redbox, and I'll fucking buy it for $1, and I'll return it that evening.
I think my highest rating would ever be just a Tuesday.
Fair enough. Moving on.
It's because she's Jewish, because she's super cheap. That's what it is.
What?
I don't...
Racist.
Dude, moving on to our next trailer, which is Concussion.
I found a disease that no one has ever seen. Repetitive head trauma chokes the brain.
The NFL does not want to talk to you.
You turned on the lights and gave their biggest boogeyman a name.
You're going to war with a corporation that owns a day of the week.
No proof was presented today because there simply isn't any.
They have to listen to us. This is bigger than they are.
What do you think they're doing to you now?
That's nothing. You have no idea how bad this could get. I have to keep going.
They want you to say you made it all up.
If they continue to deny my work, men continue to die.
I know you're going to hate me saying it. Oscar bait. This looks like Oscar bait. Because just because of the themes that's touching on, and this is very much a hot topic, even now in the NFL. And I think of the people in the room, I think Danny and I can shed some light on this because we're the most involved with
football.
Yeah.
You don't know.
Well, you know what I'll say football. Is that
I like sports ball.
This was a lot of sporting, and there was Will Smith acting super black and like African black, not like ghetto black.
Dude, but
will you stop? This is not even the worst thing I've ever said on this show.
That is true.
I'm being supportive.
Well, on the one hand, you have to realize, even though you haven't been here for 10 months, we haven't seen you in 10 months, which means, like,
we're not used to it.
That's exactly. Also not true. You have seen me in 10 months. I just haven't been on the show in 10 months. However, this movie looked amazing.
It looks like a great...
This is me being supportive. I have a skewed version of support.
No, this looks really, really good. Because this is still a hot topic in the NFL, and the NFL is still not really... all on board with this. I believe the condition is called a chronic traumatic... Oh, boy, this last word.
You can do it.
Chronic traumatic infinalophy.
Okay? Oh, I had that once, but
which
I got
is,
a shot.
Which is, yeah, basically just a condition where it's repeated blows to the head.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily just concussions. But it's just the repeated blows to the head which can cause like synapses just to misfire all the
so
time.
So are they just asking for more padding or...
The more padding is necessarily the solution, because that's been proven by like rugby players that not having a helmet is actually not that big of a deal. The added padding actually causes more trauma in certain cases.
Okay.
So more padding isn't actually the answer. They don't really have an answer right now. So, I mean, the helmet...
actually, because this is based on a true story.
Yes.
What were the after effects? Was anything changed whatsoever?
Well, one of the things that has changed is that if there is a concussion in the NFL, and this has just come up in the last couple of years, there is now a set guideline of rules that have to be checked before they can play again. There is a doctor on the sideline for each team which has to check that player. They have to say, okay, you have to pass this test and that test and that test. If they don't pass the test, they immediately go to the hospital to be checked for it. Because while this doesn't have to be from a concussion, concussions do lead to this a lot easier. Which is why the film is called Concussion. Oh, yeah.
Wait, are you saying that this wasn't the case before this happened? Like that there were no doctors on the side when football players would get hurt?
No, there wasn't.
There were just no... And there were no doctors trying to bring light to it.
Yeah.
Back in the 80s and even... I mean, obviously before, but at least the 80s. I mean, like, even if you took a blow to the head or something, you'd be like, you okay? Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah.
Right, and you'd go back in.
They would literally just, like, hold up the two fingers and say, how many fingers am I holding up? And if you got it right, they say, okay, go back in, you're fine.
They would just the referee do that? Do the two fingers rule?
It could be the ref, it could be a coach, it could be another player, it could be anyone. They would just check them real quick, see if they were alive, and if they could respond to a question, and then send them right back in.
Oh my god, what idiots.
Yeah.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Yeah. And now we're getting the fallout from that. We now have hundreds of former NFL players who are basically all but brain dead because of this. I mean, you know, they have... It's a sad statement. They have, you know, millions of dollars in the bank... And they can get the best funding, but even the best funding can't treat this. They're basically, some of them have become like vegetables. You know, there's not a whole lot they can do. And then others, their synapses are going the wrong way, and that's what this movie is going to touch on. Some players are committing suicide because they see what's going to happen to them later in life, and they're like, I don't want to deal with this.
Yeah.
And they're just offing themselves. Junior Seau, a good example. He played for the Chargers, right? Yeah, he committed suicide because he had this condition. There was another example, I think it was from the Patriots. I forget who the player was. But, yeah, it was just sad. And no one wanted to bring this to light. And finally, this one doctor, who Will Smith is playing, he's the first one to finally say, look, tell people about this. Men are dying. You know, they're putting their bodies out for this sport. And after they retire, you just don't give two shits about them. You know, and granted, they have the money to get the care, but you need to look into this. So
preventative.
Yes.
Not so much treatment, but preventative.
Right. So directing this, we have Peter Landsman. Now he directed Parkland, which is only his major release. So this is probably his biggest release up to this point. We have in this Will Smith. We have Alec Baldwin. We have Paul Reiser, which I haven't seen him in forever.
Dude, Paul Reiser. I didn't see him in the trailer.
I mean, he was in, most famously, what, Mad About You?
Mm-hmm. Right? Helen Hunt. Oh.
Yeah. But last year, he was in Whiplash. You're if you remember, so he played the dad in Whiplash.
Right, right.
Yep. We also have Luke Wilson. And wish me luck with this name. We just talked about it a few weeks ago. Adaway Akinyetan Abinje.
That was pretty good.
That was good. Yeah, well done.
Thank you.
Sounds legit to me.
Now, he was in The Mummy Returns, but he's going to be Killer Croc in The Suicide Squad. So.
Oh, the guy from Lost.
Yeah.
Mr. Echo.
Yeah.
Oh.
I can never remember. I can see his name, and I'm like, oh, yeah, Mr. Echo.
Yeah, I'm just called Adaway. I'm just going to call him Adaway. Yeah. Just pronounce the first name.
I love Mr. Echo so much, but I have zero faith in him as Killer Croc.
But. Ignoring the theme of the movie for a second, I'm just going to say I'm finally glad we're getting back to Will Smith playing a character instead of playing himself. Because in all of Will Smith's performances of the last decade, he's just playing himself. It's just, oh, I'm going to go on screen, read the lines, I'm going to be charismatic, but I'm just going to be myself. You know?
That's how good he is, though.
Well, I mean, he's good as that one character, sure, but I kind of want to see him do more than that. And admittedly, this is more than that. He's playing a character here.
He's got an accent and everything. I don't think I've ever heard him do an accent.
He's putting forth, like, a real performance here. Like, I haven't seen this since, like, The Pursuit of Happiness.
Yeah, I was going to say.
And I was like, this looks phenomenal performance from him. Like, this could be, again, Oscar bait. It looks Oscar-worthy, what he's doing here.
I am not a fan of Will Smith since, like, The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. And
what? So, like, everything?
Yeah. The English guy is like,
yeah,
what?
I know what I said. His whole career. Yeah.
I know what I said. I know what I said. This movie looks amazing. This movie, I don't even like sports or medical crap, and this movie is just amazing. His performance looks astounding.
Right.
The message looks so deep and real that, yeah, I mean, it's absolutely Oscar bait, but it looks amazing.
Right. And this ties back to something like the 33, which is, again, a big corporation trying to cover up certain facts, not letting them, you know, get out to the public. The NFL... adamantly tried to, like, cover this up and deny it for years. They knew this was happening. And they're just like, look, we're paying these guys millions of dollars. We are a multi-billion dollar industry. And, like, they say even in the trailer, they pretty much own a day of the week. You know, between September and January, they own Sunday. Yep. So...
they took that over.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot that... what can you do against a corporation this size? You know, it's like going up against... I don't know, U.S. Steel or something. You know, they're huge. So what can you do to them? And then there's this one doctor who goes in and says, you have to expose this. And they said, well, if you say anything, we're going to sue you for slander. You know, they almost got him by the balls at certain points. You know, like, what can he do? So he's just saying to them, tell the truth. Tell the truth.
Dude,
like, at the end of the trailer.
Will Smith has tears in his eyes. I'm like, I can't take it, man.
I liked Bad Boys.
Oh, okay. You liked Bad Boys.
Sorry. I don't know anything about American football, to be honest. I mean, I find it, like, kind of boring, to be honest, because it takes place, like, 60 seconds of play, and then, like, all of that break, you know, for them to set up again. But the stuff that... these kind of films where it's, like, sticking a finger to the man and taking down, like, a massive company, I just eat that stuff. I love it
As do I. I love those movies. And this is definitely hitting on all those points. It looks
tobacco used to be as big as this. Remember? And now it's like a kind of a dying business.
Right. And I'm surprised we haven't seen more films that kind of tackled that. You know, like the
Thank You for Smoking.
Thank you for one. I never saw Thank You for
It's
Smoking.
It's kind of a satire, but it's a really great movie.
Yeah. Hmm. I like
it's
it.
It's based on a book.
I think I have it.
I'll
have to check that out.
Was Aaron Eckhart
in that movie?
Yeah. I think I told you to watch this movie like six times.
This kind of time, not when smoking was accepted by everyone, like in the 60s where it was fucking massive.
Right. You know, being advertised by the Flintstones.
Exactly, yeah.
Oh, man. But yeah. I agree with you on all points on that, Nick. I think this looks like a phenomenal film. I'm pretty sure this is early Oscar bait, and I'm not going to be opening night for this, but I'll definitely check this out opening week. And this is coming out, I believe, on Christmas Day, which is what a lot of those films do. They're trying to get in for the Oscar nominations this year, so it might be actually released in like early January, but the limited release will be in December.
Week before.
So, yeah, a week before, which is what a lot of those films do. So... anyone else thoughts on this?
Looks good, man.
Yeah, I definitely want to see it.
I had a lot of thoughts and people called me a racist.
That's because you're a racist.
God. Oh, Appa.
Even Appa thinks so.
I'm not Appa? Super interested.
You're not?
Nope.
But you're a bigger football fan than I would say other people in this room.
Yeah.
Wow,
but
thanks.
You're not a football fan.
I mean, that was only aimed at me.
And Will.
Oh, really? You're not a football?
He calls it sports ball. Ball.
You don't sports?
He doesn't sports.
Do the thing with the ball and the foot.
I should have worn that shirt today.
I thought you sports.
Anyway, yes, fangirl.
Well, no, I mean, again, I think a lot of the trailers that we're going through today, while they all look really interesting, and again, they make...
All?
A lot of them. Not all of them. A lot of them, you know, Everest, 33, the 33, this one, Concussion, they all have a point to make, and it looks interesting, well made, blah, blah, blah. But, again, this is just not the type of movie for me. I don't like going in to serious movies.
Because you're afraid you're going to cry?
She's getting verklempt.
What?
You sound like you're getting verklempt.
That's a Saturday Night Live reference. Sorry.
Oh, okay. I don't know. I go in to see movies so I can escape from the awful things that are happening in the real world. And if I want to, like, I mean, it's great that it's raising issues and all this stuff. I'm going to read about it, but I don't want to put money in to see it because... Okay,
but it has a happy ending, though. It's about, like, it's like the triumph of the human spirit again with the 33. You know, the company has to make these changes. You know,
yeah.
Like, we win.
Yeah.
It's a good ending.
Yeah.
But Tom Hiddleston nor Benedict Cumberbatch are in this movie.
Yeah, if Tom Hiddleston was in it, she would be in the... she'd be first in line opening night.
Yeah.
No comment.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, moving on to our final trailer for the night, which is The Fifth Wave.
First, they took our power, throwing the world into chaos. Then they took our cities, laying everything to waste. Next, they took our lives with an unstoppable airborne virus. Worst of all, they took control. The others were already among us, exterminating anyone who survived.
The others are readying themselves for the fifth wave.
They have the ability to inhabit human hosts and control their actions. They look just like us.
What do we do now?
Be there for each other.
We can't trust anyone anymore.
How are we supposed to fight the others if we don't know what they are?
I'm not that shallow, guys.
Tell me first about this movie, because it's the first I've ever seen of it. Is this like one of those Twilight books?
Yes.
That's been made into
you,
a movie.
You beat me to it, Nick.
It's another young adult.
Oh, is that
one,
what this is?
One critic has summed up the book. This is based off a novel. One critic has summed up this book as it should do for aliens what Twilight did for vampires.
So ruin them?
No!
Yeah.
No! That's a bad movie!
Ow.
No!
Why? Don't
but
do that.
They have a
excuse
good
me,
cast,
talking gun barrel?
Though.
Will you shut the hell up for a second?
But I like the cast.
I like a cast member.
I like two, at least.
Yeah.
What was the second?
Wait, who's
Chloe.
The first? Chloe, I like. And I like Liev Schreiber.
Liev Schreiber.
Oh, yeah.
Schreiber.
Schreiber.
Liev Schreiber.
Not that hard.
All right.
It's hard.
The
it's hard
ones
for
that
me.
He pronounced are ridiculous. You can't say Schreiber.
Nope.
Yeah, nope. I can't do that. I don't want to see another genre like go the way of Twilight. I'm sorry.
Didn't they do that already with the host?
You beat me to it again. Yes. This is...
Oh, sorry.
No, did wait. You not hear what Danny said earlier?
Mike, you're fired.
England is ahead of us.
Yeah. By like 12 hours.
He knows what you're going to say.
No, that's okay. Yeah. This is very much similar to The Host, which is by Stephanie Meyer, which came out like 2 years ago, which was a god-awful film.
Wait, didn't she do Twilight?
Yes, yeah. She did.
Yeah.
Oh,
and
goodness.
She wrote this story about... these aliens that would come
yeah,
down
I,
and like
I
parasitic would latch into human beings, and then this girl
then
falls in love with one of them inside a guy.
Who was that? Who was in that?
She had eyes.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
That Irish chick. Forget her name.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that one.
With blue eyes.
That's why Danny was interested.
But yeah, that one was crap. It was one of the worst films of that year. And now here's this movie, which is almost the same thing.
I mean, you know, I've been very against all of the Tweeny Bopper book made into movies. I mean, I really enjoyed Harry Potter as a book. The movies weren't awful. The Twilight crap, I didn't even watch. I think I watched part of the second one, or I might have watched the whole thing, and that was awful. But like some of them aren't bad. Like The Maze Runner was surprisingly good.
The Hunger Games?
The Hunger Games is really, really well done. I fought that until the third one came out, and then I binged through the first two, and then went to see the third one.
Yep.
That was really well done. This one, the trailer didn't seem to have enough substance to it. I didn't know it was a book series, but it just didn't seem to have anything going for it.
Right.
It opened with this, with the host, basically, which is what I thought it was.
Right.
And then I don't know, did a flashback to, like, before things happened? Or...
Right, of the four other waves. Because it's called the fifth wave, which is what is the parasitic things come down.
It didn't seem interesting. It's really what it was. It was a lot of people got together, shot some scenes, said, this is aliens, and that was it.
Well, sorry, fangirl, real quick.
I like the trailer.
Okay, well, let's touch on some of the finer points before we get into it.
Typical fangirl.
So, the director of this is Jay Blakeson. Now, he's a British director. He only directed one major film up until this point, and he directed The Disappearance of Alice Creed, which I have not seen, but I've heard very, very good things about. In this, we have Chloe Moretz, of course, from Kick-Ass and the remake of Carrie.
She's amazing.
I like her. I think she's a phenomenal young actress. We have Nick Robinson, who was recently in Jurassic World. He played the older brother in Jurassic World.
And he's also in Melissa and Joey on ABC.
I don't know what that is.
That was really Joan Hart. Even for me.
Whoa. And as you mentioned, we have Lee Shriver, who is in X-Men Origins Wolverine. He's currently in Ray Donovan, which is apparently a good series.
He's going to be in the next X-Men movie.
Is
he? The next X-Men Wolverine movie.
Oh, okay.
Sabretooth?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And he was also in The Butler a couple years ago. I'm going to say right now, before even just talking about the trailer itself, this is really setting itself up to be the next Hunger Games series. Because
Divergent didn't do it.
Divergent has flopped. Yeah, Divergent
did it? Yeah. I thought Divergent was awesome.
Well, it hasn't done well, and it hasn't really been responded to well by critics.
I don't think it was awful. Like, it was in Twilight awful, but it also wasn't...
It was just middle ground.
It was
right.
Good, but it wasn't great, and it wasn't amazing.
Right.
Yeah, like, I fought it until... I think I fought the first one, and Steve saw it. He was like, you actually will really like this movie. Give it a chance, and... I did. I really liked that. Although I kept getting confused with the trailer of the new one, and I'm like, when does this bitch get a haircut? Like, yeah. And he's like, that's the second movie. And I was like, oh, okay.
But yeah, when this movie is released, which is this coming January, Hunger Games will basically be over.
Yeah.
It would have been released. It would have been out for about a month and a half, 2 months by that point. And Hollywood is already saying we need the next big thing. And no, it's not going to be Divergent. That's just not going to happen.
She was supposed to play Mary Jane.
Yes, she was. Which I'm kind of happy she didn't.
That movie sucked anyway, it didn't matter.
Yeah. I'm looking at this and I'm like, this isn't gonna be it. I mean, first off, you're releasing your next big thing in January, which is a dumping ground. Never ever ever release your movie in January. I know we just had to talk about that last week.
Yeah.
But it's basically a curse to release your movie at that time.
Well, do you think that The Maze Runner could take over as the next?
Because
the first one was really well done. I don't know how it did in box office, because that's your...
It did all right.
That's your deal.
It did decent numbers.
I do story.
And that could be. That could be something that could carry that flame.
It's interesting. I liked it. I liked The Maze Runner.
I mean, the second one has a really... Like, they bumped up the cast in the second one. You've got Littlefinger, a couple other people.
We're going to talk about that in a little bit, if that's okay.
I was just thinking.
That's feature presentation.
Right. Oh, is it? Yeah, oh, yeah. I was just thinking, like, if you thought that this could be the next thing, just because of the stops they're pulling out for.
Right, right, right. But like,
I'll say one thing about this movie. It wasn't clearly a teeny bopper movie right from the get go.
No, it wasn't.
No. Yeah. I didn't know it was. I just thought.
I had no idea it really was until you kind of told me, and then when you started naming the cast,
yeah,
I could clearly tell, because it's like they all seem to have this love triangle formula with each one of those movies. It's always like one girl who's got plenty of options. I mean, what was that, Maze Runner? She has like 10 guys.
Yeah. She's the only girl.
Yeah, she is the only girl.
She's the one scene in Eurotrip.
20 teenage boys, you know.
Chica! Chica!
Chica! But yeah, made a very good comparison to The Host, Nick, and this is definitely hitting all the same notes from The Host, which is not a good thing. And I'm glad that didn't become a series, because...
But The Host was clearly trying to be a teeny bopper movie. I thought this was like, oh, maybe this will be something interesting. It was only towards the end, like, this feels really similar to another movie. And but it wasn't obviously like trying to cash in on Twilight, Divergent, at the host and all
true,
of that.
True, yeah. True.
And I think what I liked about it, I'm hoping that, you know, we're going to see a development of a good, strong female character, because I think that is another thing that might, you know, kind of, that's why this whole young adult fiction is, you know, coming into place, like within Hollywood and everything, is that they are promoting strong female characters. And I'm not so sure I like the love triangle thing that they're pushing, even in the trailer.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's a little... I mean, I don't want to say it's irrelevant.
But and there doesn't always need to be a love
exactly.
story.
And that's something that I've liked about the Hunger Games series, is because that's almost put on the back burner a lot.
But
you know?
It's there.
It's there, but it's not the
focal point.
Right,
yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
This looks like, towards the end, it's becoming the focal point.
Yeah.
But one of the things in the Hunger Games is that when they did make it like a focal point in the first movie, it was as a mock.
But it was necessary to progress the rest of the
right.
film.
Right, right.
So I mean, I for one am super sick of love stories having to be an act. I mean, I don't remember which.
I'm sick of it having to be in love with an alien.
With anyone. I mean, what is this the final trailer? Was this? No, it was this trailer. Danny and I were talking, and we were like, oh, yep, and they're going to have sex. Oh, look, yep. There's the scene right there. Like, it's that theory of, like, well, the world's about to end. Let's fucking, let's go fuck. Batman goes, I have 13 hours to save Gotham. Hold on, I need a shit ton of oil, and I need a really good paint artist. I have to burn some shit on this bridge. Like, it's a waste of time.
But it makes you feel good.
It doesn't make me feel good. It makes
sex.
You feel nauseous.
Sorry, sex makes you feel good, is what I meant.
With Liev Schreiber.
It's the dogma theory. World's going to end. Might as well fuck. As far as this is concerned, no. I could not care less about this movie. It's not just that it's a young adult genre. Because, again, there are young adult films that are quite good. We've mentioned The Hunger Games. We mentioned Harry Potter. You know, this genre can be done well.
Divergent. But, I like Divergent.
But let me say, am I the only one who's weirded out at the fact that all these young adult stories are all post-apocalyptic? Like, there's always been, like, some sort of traumatic event. Like, let's riddle off a few. Okay, so you got Hunger Games. You've got Divergent. You've got Ender's Game. You've got The Giver. You've got, someone help me out here. I mean, there's tons of
a reason for that, though. It's because, at those scenarios, the teenagers have full control over their lives.
And if you tried to make one now, teenagers suck.
You're like, I want to go out with this vampire, but my dad says I can't. So, yeah, it's the movie right there.
Yeah, okay,
that's a fair point. Yeah. All right.
Teenagers nowadays suck. They've got their huge-ass headphones, and their faces are stuck in their phones. And, like, they don't do anything. They whine about fucking One Direction.
Like, wow.
I don't want to watch that movie.
Okay, fair enough.
So they actually have something to bitch about in these movies.
Yeah. Right. Like, legit, they're like, oh my god, One Direction broke up, and I just don't like how Miley was talked to by, and I'm like, shut up, shut up, shut up! Why can't I mute the real world? In these scenarios, like Nick said, it's something worth actually complaining about. They have something to fight for.
I want to get back to the post-apocalyptic films that are like The Road. Where, you know, it gets back to, you know, not just young adult stories. I want to get back to the post-apocalyptic films where we don't have to worry about love triangles, you know? maybe that's just me. Maybe, you know, we've seen too much of this. I don't know, but like, can we just get the post-apocalyptic film where we just blow shit up and don't worry about,
yes.
like, the
like
love?
Mad Max.
Yeah, like Mad Max. Yeah, Mad Max. Fury
Road.
More Mad Max. Yeah.
And look, I don't like the love triangle, but if you want to have, like, an orgy scene, like, in Sense8, I'm okay with that.
Okay.
Well, like... And I'm saying that my two favorite genre of film are action films and romantic comedies. So
actually, mine too.
They're the best.
Give me a comic book superhero movie and The Devil Wears Prada, and I'm happy for several hours.
But they don't need to be combined, you know.
Right,
I would like to keep those genres separate, just so I can enjoy them for what they are.
Anyone, any last thoughts on this before we move on to our future presentations?
No.
Nope.
I didn't like how they kept calling them the
others. That's weird. That's really... The other, why can't
like,
just call them fucking aliens?
I feel like they're trying to like...
To be PC.
No.
PC? Like, what?
We were trying to
You can
to
call
polite.
Them aliens without being racist, because they are literally fucking aliens.
Exactly.
I think the other isn't necessarily PC either, to be honest.
Yeah, no.
The other
is not.
Racist.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's more like you can substitute anything in. if you're just calling it other.
But that's the thing. This is what America fears. America fears.
I know, that's
the
why
others.
I don't like it.
Yeah. But that's what it is, right? It's like,
I think they
that's
should have just upped
how
it.
What?
They should have just upped it and be like, you're tot. We called them over there.
Them's peoples.
You say you're a towel?
Your type.
Oh.
Your type.
We don't like your type. What was your line in the Book of Corey? We don't take kindly to your type here.
Yeah. wasn't it already used, the term the others?
Yes,
wasn't
it was a movie.
Yeah, in
with,
Lost.
In Lost? In
yeah.
Lost or something?
Yeah, but there was a movie called
The Others.
The Others
with Nicole Kidman.
Yeah, but that was different.
Yeah, those were ghosts. They referred to the other guys as the others or something, or the strangers.
Yeah,
that's true. I forgot about
the strangers was different.
It's like I feel like they probably could have come up with something a little more imaginative.
It's like they gave
up. I agree. I don't know. I haven't looked up anything about the writer of this novel. I don't know if he directly borrowed stuff from the host or not. I don't know. Maybe he just wasn't being original.
The writer of this novel was that collaboration that they did on The Simpsons.
Yeah.
The host was never original to begin with.
Oh, right.
The Body Snatchers.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, Lordy. So.
Where did this come from? Why are you saying that?
What?
I've never heard you say Lordy, and you've said it like 7 times today.
I don't know. I just say it.
Lordy, Lordy,
Lord,
Lordy,
Lordy,
Lord, 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 Lord.
I'm Lord, Lordy, Lord.
Swedish chef.
Lordy, 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 Lordy.
And last thoughts on this? No, this looks like a piece of crap. I will not
I want to see it, and okay. It does not look like a piece of crap to me.
Looks like a piece of crap to me.
Should we go through the new rating system? I'm not getting this on Redbox.
Not getting this on Redbox.
I
Maybe
am going
Netflix.
To see that.
Netflix sounds all right. I'll be up for watching that.
Yes, I would.
Yeah,
I'd
wait for
Netflix.
I wouldn't want to spend a dollar on
it. I won't watch
it.
I would rather just watch Invasion of the Body Snatchers.
Agreed.
I'd rather just watch a better alien movie.
I think I'll just watch the Avengers.
I'm 18, guys, so you can actually watch this and comment.
Moving on to our last bit, which is feature presentations. And so our first movie up is The Visit. Now, we are getting into horror season since it's getting close to Halloween, and this is our first foray into that from our good friend M. Night Shyamalan.
Shyamalama ding dong.
Yeah.
That's racist.
Boy.
But they're just old.
Yeah. Oh, we poke fun of that every time in the trailer. That all the TV spots, just like, the mom's like, oh, don't worry about it, honey, they're just old. Like, I'm sorry.
That's a horrible thing to say.
Old people aren't clawing at fucking walls and, like, asking you to jump into the oven and shit. It's like, what the
it's
fuck?
It's so
that's
she
what,
could clean
what,
it.
That's what I'm going to be doing
oven.
When I get old.
Asking kids to get in ovens?
I try to put Karen in the oven every Thanksgiving.
What?
Are you calling her a turkey?
I cut you.
That also happened. She did pull a knife on me.
No, look.
What was that?
It was a turkey.
Turkey.
That was not a turkey.
That's a turkey.
Your sounds tongue like came way further out of your mouth the first time.
Anyway.
I'm actually really looking forward to this movie.
Really?
As much as
you hate Shyamalan?
I hate Shyamalan for what he has done in the past, but I love Hansel and Gretel, so I kind of want to see it.
Did you think this is like an alternate tale of Hansel and Gretel?
A little bit. I mean, she quotes the fucking play. Get in the oven.
That's about the only similarity.
I
don't know. I feel
there was only a trailer. She might quote more.
Yeah, but no. There's always some stupid twist in M. Night Shyamalan. That's what he does, and that's what I think. I think that the twist is a reimagining of Hansel and Gretel.
I think that the twist is that it's the kids.
Yeah,
who are doing
the kids.
It. The kids are
evil.
Trying to kill the grandparents or something.
It's Danny.
Danny's the killer.
Danny's
oh God!
It's Gingers.
No, I already know.
Oh, can you tell me?
No.
No spoilers. Because
I don't do that. I looked it up because I'm not going to see this movie.
I'm not going to see this, so can you tell me later?
I am going to see this movie.
Tell me later.
I'm not telling anybody.
But then we'll just discuss it after the podcast.
Yeah, we'll
if you
look
want.
It up.
Yeah, we don't spoil anything for one online.
Just give her the URL.
I'm so over Shyamalan. I couldn't care less
about
this.
He hasn't done anything in a really long time. And
it's probably for good reason. Maybe
and
you should
I
just stop.
Like I said, he hasn't done. He's done a lot of things that have disappointed me. He's done a couple things that I've liked. I really liked both Unbreakable and The Sixth Sense. Though by the time I got around to seeing that, everybody had already ruined it for me.
Sixth Sense was 1998.
Shut up, Nick.
Exactly.
Shut up, Nick.
I mean, like the last movie he did was After Earth. You know.
Yeah. Oh wait, he did that.
Yes, that was
never
garbage.
Exactly. All right,
never mind.
Oh my God! Why did you have to remind me of that?
Hold on, wait. That actually ties in earlier to another shitty Will Smith movie.
Exactly.
Well, I fault that more to Jaden Smith, not Will Smith.
They were both awful.
They're awful. Yeah. Yeah. Even Will Smith couldn't save that shoddy movie.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Very true.
But I will actually see this on a Tuesday.
We'll see. Like the goddess and I have mentioned numerous times, horror fans will see any piece of shit just because we are horror fans.
I'm not a horror fan.
But I don't want to watch this.
I think we have to see it, though. I'm sorry.
But I don't wanna.
She's like, now by weed, you mean you?
She's gonna break up with me for that week. I think we should go see this movie. I think we should see other people. So I saw this movie and I didn't like it. Good. You want to get back together? Also, I'm not going to see that movie.
Anyone last thoughts on this? I mean,
nope.
No.
I'm not usually alone.
Nick, anything?
Nah, all right.
Okay.
I'm not usually the optimist either.
Yeah. Moving on to our next, which is The Perfect Guy. Now, we did not discuss this on the podcast because it looks really, really fucking bad. Because and also, the trailers shit. Just came out exactly. Like a week ago. I've seen no TV spots. I've seen no advertising.
I only saw one spot for it, and it was last week.
Right.
It's this past week.
This isn't getting advertised.
I saw it in theaters a couple weeks ago. I don't remember what movie I went to see. And then I've seen it on TV a couple times.
I think there were some ads on Twitter. Like one of those sponsored things.
I'm just going to say, looking at this, this reminds me of something of like a role swapped Obsessed. Like, do you remember Obsessed?
Yeah.
Yes.
Swim fan. Or, no, wait, what was it?
Yeah, you're right.
Swim fans, right? Yeah. Yeah, it looks just like that. It's just, oh, look at how bad things are between these two guys. And the one guy gets overly possessive and beats the hell out of the other. And then he's like stalking her and... And I remember there was one shot in the trailer of him just like laying under the
bed. Under her bed, yeah.
Looking
yeah.
at the camera and like holding up a finger. I'm like... Really? Like
I don't think I don't think he does that. I think that you made that part up.
No, I'm pretty sure that's what he does in the trailer.
I'm pretty sure he
make
does
that up.
I'm pretty sure he doesn't like go like this to the finger.
You need to see it too.
Oh, I was just like, I just thought he was like.
No.
He was pointing at him.
Not a finger!
Not a finger!
He's looking right at the camera,
like,
though, right?
He just
yeah.
put up
yeah,
a finger.
Right at the
breaking the fourth wall type
yeah,
of thing?
Yeah, yeah.
But he doesn't break the fourth wall. He doesn't put up a finger. But he is looking right at the camera. I don't think this will be a great movie. I think that it has a really good cast because each of the cast members are really great actors, but I think it's a really shitty movie.
And Idris Elba was in Obsessed, so...
Yes.
And that movie was a piece of shit, so...
You know what? This looks like if... this looks
Beyonce.
Like Tyler Perry remade
Beyonce?
Obsessed.
Oh.
That's what this looks like. Looks like if Tyler Perry said, oh, I liked Obsessed, let me make a movie just like that.
It but Madea's like... not in it.
Is this a Tyler Perry movie?
No, it's not.
If this was a Tyler Perry movie, Michael. Madea would show up and hit somebody with hot grits.
But it looks like it was made by Tyler Perry because it's hitting all those same points and all that same dialogue that I hate in his films.
Actually, you know what? Now that you say that, like every dinner scene that they've shown in the trailers is exactly a Tyler Perry scene.
Exactly.
You're
exactly.
Right. They've got the same Tyler Perry style music.
Right.
They do the same facial expressions. Holy shit.
Right. Thank you.
Trying not to be racist.
But no, this looks like crap. I will not be seeing this.
I might end up seeing it.
I won't even see this on a Tuesday.
I'm not even going to see if it's on TV.
Yeah, I'll only see this if I'm kidnapped in May 2, which I might be.
And moving on.
Just hold your breath till you pass out, though.
Moving on to our last feature presentation, which is The Maze Runner, The Scorch Trials.
I don't have anything to say about this.
You don't, after all the ranting you just did.
Nothing to say. I've never seen
Well, now he's spent. He said everything he could have possibly said.
Let me just say first, I haven't seen the first Maze Runner. I feel like you guys have said it looks decent. I just haven't got a chance to see it yet.
I didn't think it looked interesting at all. And then Steve saw it. And he was like, no, that, again, it was another like divergent thing. He was like, it's really good. You should see it. And then the main guy who is on Teen Wolf. He was rumored to going to be play Peter Parker. So I was like, all right, well, I'll see it because I want to see if he's a good actor and I don't want to watch it.
Okay.
And I saw it and I really, really liked it. It was really well done. It looked really goofy in the trailers because it was like, let's just run through the thing and not die, which is kind of what it is. But it's a lot better than that. Like they did a lot. There was a lot more story than you realized there was.
As far as this one, I'm actually more interested in this one because, like you had mentioned, they're introducing Littlefinger.
Littlefinger's in it,
and Game of Thrones reference. Friend? Sorry,
oh, no, I
he
haven't.
Was awful.
Oh, okay.
But you yeah, he's
Google him. You might think he's attractive.
I forget the actor's name. Peter.
No, Peter Baelish is his name.
Oh,
his Littlefinger's name.
It's Aiden something.
Sorry.
What is it?
Aiden something. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But I think he's a fantastic actor, and he looks great in this. That's one of the few reasons I'm interested in seeing this. So I might actually go see The Maze Runner just to see this.
It's really good. We might have The Maze Runner. If so, you can come over, and if we do have it, it'll probably be in 3 days.
Okay.
So you can come over and watch it 3 days.
I mean, the TV spots as of late haven't given us too much more. Just, you know, you can't last, you know, 5 minutes in the Scorch is what they call it.
Well, the Scorch is just like the outside world.
Yeah. Right.
It kind of leads you to believe that there was some post-apocalyptic happening, maybe a war or something, and that maybe... it kind of leads you to believe that there might have been some sort of trial where they're trying to find out if people are strong enough to exist in it anymore.
Right, which is so. What this the maze was basically was, which I remember the goddess making a point, like, if you only have so many humans left, why would you spend this much money on just, like
killing
them?
Right, but I think that there's more to it than that, and I think that we're going to find that out in this. Like, I kind of feel like it's going to be almost a super soldier thing, like they're making these people to try to do this, but I don't know.
Interesting.
And then there's one girl.
Right, the one girl in the universe, apparently.
The one teenage girl left. And they're just like, hey, go hang out with these dozen boys. And she's like, I'm going to get so raped.
No. Wow. Wow.
She doesn't. She's super strong. I think she, like, sucker
punches. I'm sorry. Every guy thought that. She popped up and screamed, oh, my God, she's fucked.
They haven't seen... Oh. Like I said, it was the fucking beach scene in Eurotrip where you're just like, oh, Chica. Oh, Chica.
Oh, God.
Your name isn't Chica. Why did you come over to me?
I'm just going to say, I'm interested in this. I don't know if I'm going to see it opening night, because, again, I have to see the first one first. I don't know if I'm going to find my way to see it, but I'm intrigued by it. I'm definitely intrigued by it.
Hey, I have an idea, though. If I invite you over to see it and I make you lasagna, be on time this time.
Just, come to more podcasts.
Just saying. If I invite you to dinner and a movie, show up. That's all. And don't get sick, Will.
Aw.
That's all.
It's a bit late for that.
Stipian's kind of quiet. He's nursing himself right now.
Nick knew you were going to get sick, too, because they're in the future. Should have just talked to him.
That's true.
I'll nurse you.
That's gross.
You can go.
Well, that's...
So, like,
I'll see you in 10 months.
That's okay? It for Threading and Dreading today. I want to thank the goddess for coming by.
Absolutely.
I want to thank the Black Lantern for coming by.
Boston is probably my favorite band.
Okay.
Good choice. Good choice.
I want to thank the fangirl for coming by.
Random at all. I like mimosas.
Mimosas.
See, I started something
and
new.
Thank you for bringing the donuts again. Want to thank Superhuman Aficionado for showing up again.
You know, I thought about moving to Boston, but I don't like the cold.
See what I started?
Oh, God. I want to thank the Dystopian for existing.
Just barely. It's good to be here as always.
And once again, I want to thank our special guest. Blah 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 blah.
That just happened.
Guest nest.
Yay!
Thank you, guest
nest. Thank you so much for having me on.
Thank you for coming on, Nick.
You should come on more often.
Just not this early in the morning.
Okay. Do you want to let our listeners know where they can look you up?
Yeah, if you just go on YouTube and you type in History Buffs, I'm like the first 5 videos, so go on there. I'm also on History Buffs. Twitter's are like History Buffs _ on Twitter, and then History Buffs London on Facebook. But the best way to find me is through YouTube. Just type in History Buffs there.
Okay. And if you guys want, definitely check out the Ragecast through RageSelect.com. They have some great content over there as well. So
yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, thank you again, Nick. I want to thank everyone for showing up today.
Yay. And our mascot.
And our mascot, Appa. Yes, he's being petted at the moment. Thank
the Appa-faced dog who didn't whine at all.
Yes, he was very good this podcast.
No whining.
Good boy, Will.
The last time we had him on for a podcast, he whined and it was picking up interference.
Whined the whole time, yes. And I, once again, am the Projectionist. I want to thank you all for tuning in. Have a very good night and take care.
Peace out.
Bye-bye.